Hey, this is Dr. Lamb here. Just came out of surgery, taking out the medial sesamoid. Medial sesamoiditis on a patient that's a diabetic, and she keeps on having this pre-ulcerative lesion down there at the medial sesamoid. So having this stand-up CT scanner has been a great addition to our practice. We're able to see pathology, weight bearing. We're able to cut up the foot in different sections for us to see the pathology in further detail. There's this impossible prior to having this CT scanner. So, great diagnostic tools with suspicion for with the suspicion for a problem, we could figure out a lot of different pathologies that others may have missed. So, at the Family Foot Life Center, we keep you walking, only the best for our patients.
Well, this is a case of an enlarged medial sesamoid on a patient. Medial sesamoid being right here. It's hard to see on the plain film. You could look at the lateral view right here. You can't really see much of that either. Someone else did the bunionectomy many years ago, and there you go. Not here to make it beautiful, but she has a lot of pain sub medial sesamoid. We're gonna go all the way over here. We're gonna see on the CT scan why she's feeling the pain. Right here, see that sesamoid is really enlarged, and when we did ultrasound scans, about 3 millimeters from the surface of the skin. So, having the ability to be able to go through a CT scanner like this via weight bearing is very important for patient care. And we have this available at Family Foot and Leg Center for our patients. We're able to take care of this patient immediately in the office via excision of that medial sesamoid. This medial sesamoid measured about 2 centimeters. As you may or may not know, these bones are not supposed to be that big. Supposed to be probably about 1 centimeter at most. This is the bone we're talking about, the medial sesamoid right here. There are other drawings in here, but this is the medial sesamoid. As you can see, it's supposed to be nice round. Hers is very degenerated, and again, this is how it's supposed to look. That is very normal. We all have this. There's enough fat, supposed to be enough fat right here to cushion this, but when it's enlarged and arthritic, and arthritic because it's probably repeat trauma or just arthritic from years of arthritis in the first metatarsal flange, your joint, the big toe joint, this gets enlarged. When this gets enlarged right here, sesamoid becomes almost like a rock, trying to push through the bottom of the skin. And that has happened in our diabetic patients. So again, having the CT scan and having the ability to see the CT, cutting the foot into many pieces while you're standing, it's great for us diagnostically in order to help treat patients effectively. At Family Foot and Leg Center, only the best.